In this video, you're going to see how to use Skylum's Luminar AI portrait editing tools to enhance the subject's mouth. Using the artificial intelligence inside of Luminar AI, you'll see how easy it is to affect and retouch the lips, as well as lighten or brighten the teeth. I'm Darlene from Digital Photo Mentor. I teach beginning and intermediate photographers just like you to improve your photography and to enhance your images using proper photo editing techniques. As a Skylum ambassador, Luminar AI is one of the tools that I use and recommend. If you find this video tutorial valuable, please remember to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And stick around to the very end where I'll give you an extra bonus tip. This is my lovely model, Jill. You may recognize her if you've watched some of my other videos. She was in the one where I demonstrated Luminar AI's eye enhancement sliders. So to enhance the mouth and find the tools that we'll be using to do that, scroll down to the portrait section in the tools. So those are the ones that look yellow and orange in color, and open the Face AI tools. If you don't see the ones that are labeled mouth at the bottom, like I see here, just use the little down arrow or down triangle to click on that to open or close any of the tabs that are hidden. I've already applied some of the iris and eye tools as well as the face tools, so the face light has been applied here. Moving on to mouth. What I recommend for any sliders or anytime you're doing any editing like this is to choose one slider, see what it does, and take it all the way to the extreme. I usually start with lip darkening in this set of sliders. So taking it to 100, you can see that indeed it has darkened her lips. Because she's already wearing makeup, I can probably get away with these sliders maxed out at this extreme. But I would generally recommend leaving at least the redness and the saturation ones a little bit lower to give her a bit more natural look. I like something like that. And finally, teeth whitening will do exactly what it says. It's going to whiten and brighten the teeth. This looks pretty good at this level, but make sure that you zoom out. I'm just clicking on the image to zoom in and out. Or you can also use this little view button over here to choose how to view the size of the image. Once we've zoomed out, take a look at the teeth now. To me, they seem a little bit overly too bright. Okay, so always look at the image viewed at 100% like we did to do the editing, and then back out at full image, displayed full screen, and make sure that it's not overdone. Okay, so over retouching makes it look unnatural or unrealistic. I'm just going to toggle this tool off. So the Face AI also includes the two I mentioned earlier, the Face AI and the Eyes AI and the Iris Enhancement. So you'll see those things go off when I toggle this as well. So you can see that her face is being brightened in her eyes, but look particularly again at the lips as I turn it back on. You can see that her color of her lips are enhanced and the teeth are indeed whitened. She's got pretty white teeth to begin with, so if somebody has darker teeth or some staining, maybe due to caffeine or tobacco use, you might want to increase the teeth whitening. Just be careful that it doesn't go over the top and look unrealistic. If you've already gotten some value from this tip, please give it a thumbs up now and subscribe to the channel. I have a quick question for you. Tell me, how do you edit your portraits? What software do you use, and how long does it take? Please share your thoughts in the comment area below. I'd love to know if you're using Luminar AI and if it speeds up your portrait editing workflow, as I find that it does for mine. Let's look at another example where the model is not wearing makeup. This lady is more natural looking without any lipstick on, so I'm going to use the lips darkening for her. But you can see that if I use the redness and the saturation, it doesn't really match with the rest of the tonality of her face and natural look. So I would leave those at zero for her and just work with the lips darkening. Because her teeth are not showing, there's no need at all to use this slider. The bonus tip that I mentioned to you earlier is what I would suggest that you do is when you are finished your portrait editing, save it as a template. Down in the bottom here, you can see that it says My Template Edited. And if you click these little dots, these three dots, you can save it as a template and then go and rename it whatever you want to call it. What I recommend is to do your portrait editing first before you do any other color enhancements or contrast and tonal control, and just save those as your portrait editing templates. I like to save some with a mild adjustment, a medium or moderate adjustment, and a strong adjustment. And then those can be used as starting points and tweak from there. So having those portrait templates will really be able to speed up your portrait editing workflow, and you can even apply them in batches as well. Please remember to watch the other two videos in this series on Luminar AI's face retouching tools. Just click one of the videos on the screen now. Until next time, this is Darlene from Digital Photo Mentor. See you again soon.